Hello, my name is Arjan, the creator and founder of the Greenhouse Seed Company and the Greenhouse Coffee Shops. Next to me, it's the Arjan's Haze number 2. This again is seeds that come from all over the world. We make cocktails here, we try to mix them up, we travel around, pick up nice stuff and experiment. And this again is a result of 10 years of experimenting with all different kinds of sativas. First of all, this plant grows really, really fast. In the first week it went to 17 centimeters and in the second week it went to 47 centimeters, where we are now. The container is an 85 liter container. The temperature here we keep on 25 degrees in the day and on 19 in the night. The atmosphere around us is approximately 50%, so it's a really dry, nice atmosphere, so the plants grow really fast, as you see. The pH is 5.5 and the EC is 1.9. For the third week of the Arjan's Haze number 2, this is our fastest growing sativa plant, and this week it grew 41 centimeters. You can look in the top also again here, sativa, 9 leaves now in the third week. Pretty soon we're going to put it on 12 hours to start inducing the flowering period. Also with this plant we higher the nutrients a little bit, we go to 1.6 and we raise the pH to 5.6, so it can take up better the minerals and other things. We give the plant also some enzymes now, and the temperature around this area will still stay the same. We keep it on 25 in the day and on 19 in the night, and this is Celsius. One thing I can say more about this plant, this has also the longest leaves. They are 20 centimeters long, 2-3 centimeters wide. So big sativa leaves. This is Franco, left and right hand of me, with all the growing we do. We are now in day 29. We are 5 days in our flowering period. So that's half of the week was still 18 hours and the other half was 12 hours. What we are doing here, we are basically growing the optimum possible world champion plant. So the whole environment we created here was optimum. For example, the temperature, the humidity, we all try to keep that really fantastic. The base of the plant is fantastic. We keep a certain amount of air through the root system. We give a certain amount of nutrients that we change a little bit every time. So we cut down the bottom,
trimming the branches, making some air down here. Nice and neat cut, as much as possible. Here we go, there's one some more room now.
Now you see what's left over. So what we are trying to do with this here is we are going to try to induce all the growing of the bud in nicely into the tops and into the top colors where there's more sun, of course.
I'm a little bit embarrassed when I'm standing in front of a plant that's actually taller than I am. And yeah, it gives a certain respect feeling. But yeah, it's a fantastic sativa. It's a stretcher. It's a plant that you have to give her the proper room to grow and to develop. And you have to give her the proper time as well. 11 weeks is the commercial time. It's doable in 11 weeks, but the real connoisseur has patience, and patience will be rewarded with this plant because the high of it is incredible. It's really a strain that gives you this feeling like you're floating. You're just, there's some layer in between you and the external world, and it works. It works really good. I don't know if you still can see me. Here in front of me, the tallest sativa in the collection, Arjan's Haze number 2. This is a wonderful plant. It's a plant that we have to deal with. She has some really stretchy character, and we try to minimize the effect of the stretchy genetics of the plant. And what we accomplished is this, which is still a pretty tall plant, pretty shooting plant. It's a plant that flowers in 11-12 weeks. We are now on day 14 of the flowering period, of 12 hours period. And the pH is kept at 5.9, like all the other sativas. It's 0.2 higher than the pH we keep for our indicas, and that's maximized phosphorus and potassium intake for the plant. I'm glad now to let the word to the king himself, the man who produced the genetics, who bred the plant, and Steve Ager from High Times magazine and the Cannabis Cup.
Well, it's a pleasure for me to have Steve here in the grow room. What we see here is 11 beautiful plants. I don't know how much exactly, but 6 or 7 are the old original Cannabis Cup winners. We got the famous White Widow, the White Shark, Never's Haze, Super Silver Haze, Hawaiian Snow, Arjan's Haze 1, 2 and 3, and right in front of us is Arjan's Haze number 2. This is going to be the winner in 2006, by the way.
Do you have a little poem that goes with that?
Last week, in the first week of flowering, we threw out the light 3 days to stop it growing in the top, otherwise it shoots through the ceiling.
Normally when I look at a plant, I look down, or I look here. In this case, I look like, whoa, dude, is there anybody up there? This is Arjan's Haze number 2, 21 days into the flowering, 12-hour cycle. It's kept at a 5.9 pH and a 1.7 EC in the feeding solution.
What we do, we flush at this point. We want to keep the salt buildup under control. At the moment, I'm going to leave the word to Arjen, the king of cannabis, and to our special guest here today, the editor of Buster High, the Japanese cannabis magazine.
Okay, this one, also a very famous plant. Arjen's Haze number 2. New champion. Also for Japanese customers, very beautiful plant. Because this one is a cross from Super Silver Haze and Neville's Haze. And then again, also a cross with Laos.
We keep the pH on 5.758, and then you see it 1.718. We flush regularly with 5.5 pH and 1.3, you see.
If you look at the buildup of those plants, look how nice the colors build up here. Beautiful plant everywhere. Great outdoor plant.
Yeah, it's fantastic. You can really see the structure of the Super Silver Haze flower in it, the compactness, the heaviness. But at the same time, this smell is so particular, so unique, so different. It's unbelievable. This plant is the plant that makes me believe in the synergy of cannabinoids. Because somehow the THC test for this plant came slightly lower than the one for the Arjen's Haze number 1. But still, when I smoke this plant, I get a somehow intense, more intense effect, a more clear effect. It's incredible to me. It's really the proof that the 61 cannabinoids that we know are just a little bit, and the 3 that are studied are definitely not enough to know about cannabis.
Technically, you could harvest already and smoke it if you cure it a little bit longer, but we're going to go on with this plant. So everybody always asks questions about the short time of flowering and stuff like that. Well, here you can really see, if you look at this bud, that it's full of white crystals. There are like 20% brown hairs in this plant already. And yeah, it looks very, very nice. The smell of this Arjen's Haze number 2 is fantastic. Look what a colas here. You have them all together like this. Maybe I can get them all together like this. For a haze, this is beautiful. We are also again in day 57, so the start of week 9. I think this plant has the most potential of all sativas. And as you can see how much crystals this plant already has, and you see already so many brown hairs, so this plant is far ahead of the other sativas at the moment, so it's going to finish off really quickly. That's because of the Laos that's in. You'll see that also in the midget, the Arjen's Haze number 3, that it's farther now. So we accomplished with that male to finish off quicklier, and in some situations we also accomplished to keep the plant smaller. Now, here you can see, look how big, nice the top is also of this for a sativa, and yeah, it's great. It's amazing. I think this is going to be definitely one of the plans for the growers in the next 10 years. See, the branches are getting even too heavy, Frank. They're starting to hang here. You see that?
Yeah.
The branches are even getting heavy. Really, so make sure when you grow this plant indoor, you've got yo-yos hanging on your ceiling so you can keep all the branches up. Because you see they're starting to hang everywhere. And it's pretty outrageous for a sativa. Normally you have that when in indica, but not with a sativa.
Very strong smoke as well, this plant. The highest CBD content in the 3 Arjen's Haze's. And when you smoke it, you really feel it. It's heavy on the body. It's really intense.
And you feel how hard the bud is also, Frank?
Very compact.
Very compact. Yeah. Now, starting to close. Most sativas now, you see, after 9 weeks, they don't really close yet. You know, they're still a little bit, not so hard, a little bit airy. And here with this sativa, you really see the weight on this plant. We are in week 10 now, so day 70. And basically, you can see this plant, if you look really good, you can harvest it now. Very, very tight nuggets, beautiful brown hairs, high crystal production, very, very beautiful sativa to grow in and outdoor. We decided to leave it 1 week longer, but if we look at the nuggets, Frank, basically, it could come down right now.
Yeah, it's getting really ripe. We like it nice and ripe, and we want to allow maximum THC production, so a week longer won't hurt, but for commercial purposes, it could go down today. For this plant also, technically speaking, we have started the final flush process, so we don't give any nutrients anymore. We just flush with clean water with a pH of 6.5, and we let the feeding get out of the medium and out of the system of the plant before we harvest, so not to have a too harsh of a product, but more of a sweet and original flavor.
This is one of the plants we're going to be smoking in the smoking panel. So after we're going to harvest all our 11 varieties of the Greenhouse Seed Company that we have now, we're going to have this big smoking panel with all experts there, and they all can judge the 11 top strains of the world, all champions. 11 weeks now, and we're going to harvest it today. And this is going to be a future champion. Arjen's Haze number 1 won the Cannabis Cup 2004, and this is going to win the Cannabis Cup maybe in 2006 or 2007. This is a cross of Super Silver Haze, Neville's Haze, and Laos. So basically the main 3 big winners of the last 10 years have been crossed within this plant. Look at the crystals here. really very, very white, very, very potent plant. And the smell, yeah. Here you smell the mango and you smell the Neville's haze and the super silver haze through towards the iron haze number 3, the midget. All the smells are combined here.
It's a cocktail. It's a real supreme cocktail. No. Fine smell. We implemented a feeding program with this plant that allowed us to get to this result. So after 11 weeks, the main biggest fan leaf of the plant, it's bigger than my face, by the way, it's perfectly green with no deficiencies. This is very important because this tells you that the metabolism of the plant was fine till the end, with no major stresses or problem or anything that can compromise your flower production. And now we enjoy it. Now it's time to start peeling. Big leaves. Now we're doing fine manicuring here, which is very good when you have a lot of time available and a little bit of weed to manicure. Sometimes you have to go fast. Sometimes it's just a matter of getting rid of it and making it ready. And I'm sure a lot of growers know what I'm talking about. Snip it, chop it, cut it, as long as it goes away. Bite it.
So, after 50 minutes, we finished manicuring the Ion's haze number 2. Probably one of the most potent hazes on the world. This is what's left of manicuring of this beautiful plant. So don't forget, for the future, a big time winner this is going to be. Not yet available on the market, but pretty soon on www.greenhouseseeds.nl. Don't forget to buy the seeds, Ion's haze number 2.